Right, here we are on the next one. We've got four DSIs. That one, number 8 of the 20 DS bundle, is completely mullered. It's obviously got no top screen, no, like, it's just no good. So that is four spare parts. Number 9 does not charge. Number 10 needs a lower LCD. It needs the case swapping out because it's all cracked around here and here, and doesn't read cartridges. And number 11 just needs a top LCD screen, I think. But right, let's start with number 9 and let's find out why this doesn't charge. Hopefully, it's just a fuse. So it doesn't charge, but we know this blue one has got a charged battery. So let's just try that charged battery in here. Yes, it powers up. Touchscreen registers. And the cartridge slot reads. So, does it charge? With that battery in? No. So yeah, let's get that open. So I reckon it is the fuse 2. Right, let's find where F1 and F2 are. Right, let's have this out. Right, let's well, F1 works, or F2 even. And F1 works, right. Well, let's take this out. What does this do? If we plug it in, that does charge. So let's get this out of the way. Bearing in mind, number 8 is going to be the donor for all of these with any luck. Get that out of the way. Well, that's gone straight in the spares box. Right, let's try this straight away. Do we have any light? So, no, still nothing. Could be that charging port. Oh, well. So we know these, this is good. Try it again. Power's on, but There we go, and it charges. So let's have it back together, and that's the first one sorted. Right, before I do that, take that one off. I think the other one's on there as well. Yep. So that just needed a couple of dabs of solder on there, on the charging port. Right, where's the back to this? Right. There we go, charging up nicely. Happy days. Does not charge? Does charge. One down. Now, what have we got? We've got this blue one that needs a top LCD. Make sure this charges before we get too involved. Yep, that charges. Happy days. Right, let's pull it apart. Right. Get that out of the way, that out of the way. Right, pop that board there. Screen can go on top so I don't muller it. Let's have one. That's four of those out. Let's get the four screws out. Right, let's poke the hinge in. Now we've got to worry about these two cables. Unlike the DS Lite, we've actually got a camera cable in here as well to concern ourselves with. So pop that out from there. this silver epoxy thing is causing issues. Right, okay, so that's out. Right, that's that through. Let's try and twist this up. Okay. Let's retrieve a brand new DSi top screen. There we go. We'll have one of them. Peel this off like we do with the DS lights. Let's see if it works the same here. I can't remember the last time I've done a DSi top screen, so that's sat on there nicely. Wake the soldering iron up. There we go, there's one on. Now, yep, that's going to go like that. So let's unpick this. Oh, I don't think that's gone through very well. Do you, people? No. Oh, I might have ruined that already. These are horrible to try and fit. Right. That is not fitting well, but let's have a look. I want to see if it works before I try and tidy it up. I can't put the top on properly until I've got it back in here. Here we go, that's the hinge back in. So now I can try and get this. Well, that's together. No idea if it's going to work. Because that could have been a camera fault rather than it being the top screen. But we'll find out momentarily. Oh, I don't need to put that in yet. That needs to go in. That needs to go in. Right, I want to see that top screen working, and then I want to see the camera working. Good, power's up. Right, put the buttons back in and I will have to connect that touch screen up. that's that clipped back down. Right. Go, that's the way to get that on. Go. Oh, I need to put some screws in the top. Does it read cartridges? Oh, look, it's been to CX before this. Happy days. Right, so apart from putting the screws back in there, once I can find them, this one's done as well. So, two of the four are going concerns now. The last one, obviously, because number 8 is just spare parts. The last one needs the case swapping out and the cartridge slot. So that'll be a fun one. The cart slot will be interesting, but yeah, so happy days. Right, there's that one. Okay, so this one here, cart repair, K case swap lower LCD. It does turn on. Just try and clean that up. Yeah. Right, so we don't need to do the lower cart reader. We just need to change the back of the top and the back of the back. The lower touch screen. Right, okay. Let's have that apart and get that nipped up. Right, now that's knackered, but this cable might be good, so I'll hang on to that. And we'll have this one here, but that'll go on in a minute, because first of all, I need to pop this out, pop that out. Right, so this is coming out. This one over here, pop this out of the way for a second. Let's lift these cables. Get the screws out. So we don't know if this board works or not, but I'm quite sure we can find out at some point. I'm going to put a sticker on it, just because I don't know if it works or not, and I want to. I need a pen. To test. Right. We'll find out about that later. In the meantime, this screen, we're going to test and see if that's any good. Where's the knackered one? Right. Let's bring this back again for a second. Pop that there. Pop this here. Because I need to... We know the touch screen works, but the actual LCD's looks like it's water damaged. So that there, and we'll get this one. Peel that off. Fit that on there, and then we can discard this again and put this one in here, and let's see what happens. Hopefully this lower screen is good. I don't like that. That doesn't seem to fit properly. Nick one out of the other thing. That just looks weird. Oh, I don't like it. Feels funny as well. Ugh. Touch screen in. Couple of screws on this side. One that side. Dab of super glue there. And then we'll work out which way it's meant to go. Done that first. Right, there we go. That's glued in place, and by the time we get this together and ready to screw back together, sorry, that should be dry. So, have we got a charged battery? Not that one. Touchscreen's looking all right. Yeah. Happy days. Does that camera work before we get carried away? I just want to switch the camera. Oh yeah, it's because my hand's in the way of the rear camera. Okay, jolly good. Back to normal. Take that battery off. I actually need to take this all apart entirely, because that is done here as well, so. This one here will provide the case for it, I suppose. Ugh. I've got no idea if these screens work. Probably not though, because cables are missing. Might as well get this to pieces again. No, you can stay plugged in that. Just the two screws. Buttons can come out. Just go there for a minute. Because we need to remove all of these. Is that going to come up clean? Amazingly, it looks like it is. Huh, who knew? Just have a look at this top one. Will whatever's written on there come off as well? Oh, it's got to go in a bin anyway. Why am I bothering? Straight in the bin. Checking the spares box for a I don't seem to have one apart from this one, which has got a camera fault on it, so that's neither here nor there. Now what? That's that one dealt with rather swiftly. And then we need to just have it like that. Pop this through here. There we go. And then this can come off. I'm gonna move that top out of the way because it's not making my life any easier. Let's just snap this off. Where's the snippers? Seeing as this is knackered, I don't know why I'd make my life more difficult. I can just poke them around that and get this out of the way. Right, and it can go straight into this one. I'll be surprised if these work once they get back in there. It feels like I'm practically tearing them. Just can't seem to is this little outline of the camera one at the back? There we go. We could be in business. I hope we're in business. Where's this hideous thing? Go through there and then pluck it through a little bit. Right, hopefully that will just close up and clip in. Some screws on it. We'll have this little power board out of here. D-pad. Power button's already in there, so get out of the way. Plastic bit in. Half an hour to get this onto the computer, get the video finished and get it on the computer, because I want to go and watch the Formula One next. I'll listen to the football, but I'm not listening to the Formula One. get these located as best we can. Yeah, I'm going to go and watch the Formula One and then come back and get today's post done because it's, well, quite frankly, mounting up something ridiculous. And I need to get the post done because it's approaching Christmas and people want their Christmas stuff. Hopefully, this will be sorted. I mean, there's a big dose of hopefully because you never can tell. It sort of worked 10 minutes ago, but who knows? After I've wiggled those wires about quite so much. If I remember right, this was the easy way to do that, wasn't it? Yes, it was. Right, probably a good idea to put a battery in. Powers up. Makes a noise. Touch screen works. Does the camera work? Set all of this up. Yep, you can see the blue mat and bits and pieces. But, oh look, it's me! And my little Roll Muck t-shirt. Here. That's just the top of my head. Oh, I don't want to do anything there. Oh, I can't bother. Why do we have to do all of this? Well, yeah, that's enough of that. I've just got to screw this back together and away we go. So I'm going to leave it there and put it back together. Nobody wants to watch that. And thanks very much for watching. I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.